Since House of Glory's return, I pin New Japan's Rocky Romero. I pin New Japan's TJP. Cause I'm on a roll, I'm on a mission. And Charles Mason, tonight's the night. Cashless be coming to three-time House of Glory Crown Jewel Champion. You get ready, cause can't nothing stop cash flow. Cause at the end of the day, I have everything to gain, and you have everything to lose. If it don't make dollars, it don't make sense. Squad!
From a sold-out NYC arena, House of Glory Wrestling is bringing you this YouTube exclusive match.
The Crown Jewel Championship is on the line as Charles Mason defends his title against Ken Broadway.
Charles Mason's descent into madness has been well documented with a series of ruthless attacks on members of the HOG roster, including Ken Broadway.
You reek of poverty. But what else should I expect? You are from Harlem, aren't you? Now you may have all these people fooled in here with this jewelry, wearing designer clothes. We both know where you came from. I am generational wealth. I am old money, and you are nothing more than chunk change. You street thug. Now House of Glory has invested quite a bit in you, and I don't think they've gotten their return. And you know what they say, Kenny? If it don't make dollars, then it just don't make sense.
Ken Broadway had a chance to get revenge on Mason in a triple threat Crown Jewel Championship match.
I got my eyes on him, but as long as you got that Crown Jewel title, I got my eyes on you too.
Lowkey was set to defend his title against both Cashflow and Mason, but once again, Charles Mason attacked Broadway, which resulted in Cashflow being rushed to the hospital, and the match became a one-on-one match between Mason and Lowkey. Victory for Charles Mason, but an effective one, as he is your new Crown Jewel Champion. He's set to make his first title defense in just a few moments, but first, House of Glory's marquee event returns this summer as we present High Intensity live from Terminal 5 on August 28th. The card is shaping up to be a big one with several must-see matches. Lowkey and Killer Kross collide as these two skilled assassins go head-to-head for the first time on August 28th. It will be House of Glory versus the House of Black as Malakai Black returns to House of Glory to take on the Amazing Red. And speaking of returns, we have a huge announcement for all of you. HOGWrestling.net, and the event will also stream live on Fight TV.
House of Glory Wrestling is the best wrestling in New York State.
Head over to shophog.net
to get your hands on some official House of Glory wrestling merchandise. From shirts, hoodies, hats, and collectibles, shophog.net is the one place to go for your official HOG gear.
We are just moments away from our feature matchup. Cashflow Ken Broadway has a chance to become the first man to three-peat as the House of Glory Crown Jewel Champion when he battles Charles Mason. He's been on an impressive hot streak of late and has a chance to cap it off with championship gold. Can he make history by putting a quick end to Charles Mason's reign of terror? We'll find out next. Prizes to be named in the weeks ahead. Tickets are on sale right now at hogwrestling.net. The event will also be available to stream on Fight.
Mason makes his way to the ring. Let's take a look at the chilling message he sent to the HOG roster following his Crown Jewel Championship victory.
I just knocked out one of the most feared men in all of professional wrestling. I am the new Crown Jewel Champion. I am the new face of fear in pro wrestling. I am the root of all evil. Eat the poor, feed the rich.
Charles Mason has put HOG management in a very difficult position, and there are rumors they may ask him to go see therapy. If you ask me, it's not enough, and at some point, you have to ask yourself, is it even safe enough to keep this guy on the roster?
I disagree, JD. Like most wealthy and successful men, Charles Mason has a touch of sadism that was required to get him to where he is today. The only difference between Mason and the others is that he doesn't try to hide his dark side. He embraces it, and for that he should be praised. He should be admired for his transformation. The billionaire playboy is dead. Long live the root of all evil.
Here we are. It all comes down to this.
David Adams with the official announcement.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, this is your main event of the evening. It will be scheduled for one ball. And it is for the HOG Crown Jewel Championship. When the bell sounds, the many command, your official, Mr. Nick Shinna. And now the combatants who get set for war. Introducing first, he stands in the corner to my right, heavily known as Money Making Manhattan. Weighing in at 225 pounds, Butch Challenger. He is the Squadron General,
between these two men is as stark as it could be.
Well,
Charles Mason, as he talked about before, is generational wealth. He knows how to invest his money, to build things in this world. He doesn't waste it all on strip clubs and cheap gold jewelry the way Ken Broadway does.
Well, Mason says that Broadway is a fraud. He calls him a fraud. He, you know, look, he's a man of money. He thinks that Ken Broadway throwing around all this money, he doesn't actually have it. It doesn't belong to him. He thinks apparently he's the only one with money. But you mentioned before, Ken Broadway, no stranger to that Crown Jewel title. And I don't know if you know the significance of this, but today is actually a very significant day because it was 5 years ago to the day today that Broadway last held that Crown Jewel championship.
Big clothesline over the top rope. Broadway already taking it to Charles Mason.
He lost the championship that day to Leo Rush.
That's a long time to not hold the gold.
And what a match that was.
281 days. It's a long time indeed.
Ken Broadway feeling it right now. You sense his energy. Is at an all-time high. You talk about generational wealth, Doctor. Charles Mason said to Ken Broadway, as of today, wealth is not your birthright as it is mine. Therefore, this mockery of my people will cost you your life.
kill the poor to feed the rich. And according to Charles Mason, whatever amount of money Broadway happens to have at any time, he is poor in spirit.
281 days as the Crown Jewel champion. It's been a lot longer than 281 since he's held it. And look at...
crawling away like the coward he is.
Like slime. He's trying to slink away like Broadway wasn't going to notice.
Well, guys, this is a dangerous situation. As you mentioned earlier, Jason, Broadway went off that ramp last show, and look at him, he's looking to do it again. This sick, vile individual. Who knows if Ken is 100% tonight?
Charles Mason is a champion, and he's going to do whatever it takes to hold on to that title.
Ooh, right into the arms of Ramirez, the insurance policy already paying off. And Ken flies off the ramp and takes both Ramirez and Mason out.
You know, it's hard enough to be in the ring with Charles Mason. We don't have to like the guy. I think we both understand he's very good in the ring.
Yes.
But he's got to have eyes in the back of his head. He's got to contend with both men.
If Broadway could neutralize Ramirez, then maybe he'd have a tiny chance of defeating Charles Mason.
Well, he has so far. I don't know how long that's going to last.
Big overhead chop there by Charles Mason.
Now, is Mason flying back to Dubai tonight? Does he have the red eye back to Dubai? Do we know?
Probably. I don't know.
I don't know that he wants to spend too much time here in New York. I would imagine he'll immediately go back.
Certainly not around these people in Queens.
Oh, we're not. Now back inside goes the champ.
Broadway rolls back into the ring with Charles Mason in the center of the ring now. Ken's slight hesitation there, looking at the Hog Faithful. Charles Mason took advantage.
And Mason mocking
up
Matt
to his
Kravitz
feet
there.
With a jumping elbow. Did Broadway want two?
Mason may have enraged Broadway there with that taunt.
Don't forget, the next time you can catch House of Glory live is on August 28th as we present High Intensity live from Terminal 5 in New York City. We'll see action from the House of Black, Killer Cross, Low Key, and more surprises to be named in the weeks ahead. Tickets are on sale now at HOGWrestling.net, and the event will also be available to stream on Fight TV. Broadway now setting him up. Nice springboard dropkick there by Ken. Broadway takes Charles Mason to the outside.
Keep your eye on Broadway. He might be about to fly.
Has been known to do that from time to time. Full head of steam there.
Of course.
And the slingshot DDT by Charles Mason.
Classic, brilliant tactics from the root of all evil.
And the basement dropkick sends Broadway to the outside.
That's why he's the champ.
This is our crown jewel. Do you believe that?
Now look at what's going on here.
And he's faking an injury.
He's got Nick Shin distracted.
Faking? What are you talking about?
Yes,
faking.
Look. Has Ramirez the insurance policy on the outside.
He tweaked his knee. Charles Mason tweaked his knee.
Throws Broadway into the barricade right behind Nick Shin's back.
Oh, good. He's healed.
Miraculous. Must have been the trip to Dubai.
Thankfully. Well, he does have the best doctors there.
I'm sure he does. Lobbing forearm shots by Mason. Two count there by Charles Mason. Doesn't hook the leg. Everybody watching on Fight, just watch the facial expressions of Charles Mason. What you saw at the beginning of the match, it will develop into a more maniacal Charles Mason as this match goes on.
He is a passionate, intense individual when it comes to his work here in that squared circle.
It's basically a handicap.
Look at this guy. Who allowed him to be out here? Where is
Money
Brian
well
XL?
Spent.
Where is Amazing Red? Where? Suplex by Charles Mason.
They're counting their money like anyone else would, having a champion like Charles Mason back in the seats.
Head over to shophog.net to get your hands on some official House of Glory wrestling merchandise, from shirts, hoodies, hats, and and collectibles. ShopHOG.net is the one place for you to go for your official HOG gear.
And Mason seems to relish both hitting Broadway and getting hit.
Oh, that seemed to be a little low below the belt there by Ken Broadway. Big move by Charles Mason. Oh my God!
It looked like Broadway was going for the rebound.
Look at this sick bastard. Look.
He had it scouted.
Charles Mason feeds off of suffering. He feeds off of competition.
Looking at the House of Glory faithful here.
Looking down at them.
As he should, he is so far above any of these pestiferous dunderheads here in the HOG arena.
Charles Mason took too much time there in a big right hand by Broadway. Them out.
Look at who's
Mason's motion.
Look at who's stalking Broadway. That's what I mean. Eyes in the back of your head.
Broadway has an opening here. He should capitalize quickly if he wants to win that title.
I don't necessarily trust Charles Mason. He seems to be out on his feet here.
He's not moving. He's like dead weight.
Broadway struggling to lift Mason up. Can't get him up.
And he can't win the championship if he can't get him back in the ring. He's got to break the count.
Exactly what he did.
The more time it takes Broadway to get Charles Mason.
Look at this. Wow. Charles Mason playing possum on the outside.
Another
Jason.
Incredible recovery from Charles Mason. He is so resilient.
Miraculous. It must have been the great doctors in Dubai, right?
They'll be more than happy to take this count out victory.
Of course he would. He's a coward.
He's a champion. And if he, and if Broadway gets counted out here, Charles Mason will still be champion.
Well, he's going to have to come up with a plan B. That didn't work.
Don't put your hands on the official there. Nick
he was counting quite slow.
He'll be more than happy to get disqualified. Yes.
Going for that Hangman's DDT again.
Goodness.
Knee to the face. This time hooks the leg, and Ken Broadway gets that right shoulder up.
Look at this.
Look at the facial expression.
It's just the
Jason is beginning to grow in power, to grow in focus and intensity.
Veins popping out of his head. He's so frustrated. Big headbutt by Charles Mason. Atomic drop.
Manhattan drop, followed by a huge lariat. But Broadway still has more in him.
Nice string of offense there by Charles Mason. Simplistic.
Mason,
yet effective.
He remains in control. He remains dominant.
Broadway's been waiting an entire month to get this opportunity. It was taken away from him by this man last month. Gets it one-on-one.
If there's one man, Jason, that Charles Mason does not want to be in the ring with for that House of Glory title, it is Ken Broadway, the crown jewel of House of Glory. If anybody knows what it is to hold that championship, it's Ken.
Absolutely. Well, that's why he did what he did last month. It was in his mind, it was the only way to ensure victory. Even that wasn't guaranteed, but he walked out with the title.
Irish whip by Ken Broadway. Mason leaps over, kick to the midsection.
Another one.
Going for that. Oh, there it is. That's that.
Guillotine.
Guillotine.
Gonna suck the life out of Ken Broadway. He's fading.
He can't allow himself to fall. If he falls, it's gonna be curtains for him. He's fighting his way out of it.
Ken Broadway's got that upper strength advantage here over Charles Mason.
Does he have enough left in him
Looking
to lift
for
him
the
here?
Suplex up. He's got Mason in down with the brain buster.
Right on the back of Mason's skull.
That'll create the separation that Ken Broadway needs as Nick Shinn starts his 10 count.
Broadway needed that. He needed that the
yes,
worst
he
way.
Did.
And now whoever can get to their feet first may very well win this contest.
A Mason trying to get to his feet. Broadway.
He sees that. He just pointed at that crown jewel title.
They're up at the same time. Locks that right hand. Tells Broadway. And another one. There's that step up kick by Broadway. We're starting to feel it.
Broadway has a chance.
Michinoku driver down.
It's not enough to defeat Charles Mason. Broadway trying to build momentum, appealing to these morons out here to give him that extra little bit that he would need to defeat Charles Mason.
And Broadway may be taking just a little bit too much time here. Going up for another move.
No, back to the guillotine.
He had it locked in, though. I don't think he does.
This time, Broadway powers Mason into the corner. Broadway hits chest first. He goes for that sleeper hold. We've seen that applied many times before.
Rear naked choke. He doesn't have it quite locked in yet.
Mason may be looking for the body scissors here. He gets that. It's all over.
Mason's got to get his left hand under his right arm.
Oh!
He heard suplex!
God! Wow.
Somehow, Broadway is alert. I don't know how, but he is.
Mason now looking to take advantage with the Meteora in the corner.
Double knees to the face.
Wow, rolling DVD by Mason, too! And 3/4. How Kent kicked out of that after that suplex, Jason? I have no clue.
I don't even know if he knows that he kicked out. I think he may have just done that on instinct.
The tie's coming off.
What is Mason going to have to do to put this guy away?
The top button's becoming unbuttoned.
What? We can lock in that guillotine again now.
That's usually what happens with buttons. They get unbuttoned. What is it going to take to put him away? See, I get scared when Mason gets desperate. I get worried. There's no telling what this man is going to do.
I'm worried for just him being in the building.
I'm worried about the man in his corner. I'm keeping an eye on him. I don't trust him.
Right now, Charles Mason has devious machinations. Something in mind for Ken Broadway.
Ken is going to do everything he can to stop that. Big headbutt rocks Mason as he's holding on the top rope and looking to slip through. He does successfully. This is vintage Ken Broadway here going for that backstabber.
We've seen this before.
Oh, yeah. We know what comes. He's looking for that currency kick. He hit it.
That could be
it. He hit it. Cover. I don't believe it. I don't believe it.
La Sombra
Pena. Get this guy out of here.
Once again.
And this,
yes,
this
finally.
Just ejected him from ringside.
But can he make him leave?
Oh, he's going.
This is the best decision all night.
Broadway's got to pay attention here. He's got to keep his eye on the prize.
Broadway let Ramirez know how he felt. Ken also looks to be busted open in the mouth.
Currency kick again?
Possibly. He went for it again. Charles Mason seen that one coming. Maybe going for another suplex. Oh, big lariat turns. Broadway inside out, hooks the leg cover.
Not quite enough.
What a battle for the Crown Jewel Championship.
What's it gonna take for either one of these men to be victorious here tonight at Holy Grail?
Look at this guy slapping Broadway. Broadway is on Dream Street right now, dead weight. He's up. Big knife edge shot, still out on his feet.
Stiff forearm from Charles Mason there.
This is a battle of wills here between these two.
War of attrition, as it were.
Who's going to fall first?
How much more energy do they have, gentlemen? They are exerting every last bit of energy they have right here.
Any one of these strikes could put either man down.
Big boot by Mason. Slingshot by Broadway. Big rolling elbow takes Mason down, and Ken goes down with him.
If Broadway had just fallen on Mason there, he might have won the match. But Mason had the instinct to roll out of the way as he fell.
What is Ken Broadway doing now? Has Mason hooked up?
Travis Plex, no.
Charles Mason planning to do here. Look at this. Oh my God. Another chokehold.
He's got it locked in. Submission here.
It's locked in.
All Ken has to do is get that foot underneath the rope or on that rope there. I don't think he knows where he is.
No. The ropes are close, but he doesn't know.
He didn't get the rope. He got it.
He's got it. If that was in the center of the ring, this would be over. This match would be done. This match should have been done after that currency kick.
You don't know that.
Well, Ramirez thought so. That's why he got involved. He got bounced. So now it's one-on-one, but it might be too late. If Broadway doesn't get up.
Nasty stomp.
This is just insult to injury now. Mason.
And more injury.
Look at this guy. Put in the boots to Ken Broadway. Trying to lift Broadway up.
Might be thinking Reign of Terror here.
Big headbutt by Ken Broadway. Charles Mason doesn't know what area Cody's in. Oh no, Nick Shin accidentally eats a boot.
There's the trap.
Coming down. One. What is this?
What is this?
Charles Mason kicks out at the last moment.
Who is this clown? I knew there was something suspect about this guy.
You know what? I didn't like his
face. Who is this guy?
But he's a good referee.
It's the slowest count I've ever seen.
Oh, no.
Broadway, from the moment, and you see it, he's back out now. Ramirez, from the moment he came out here, he had the deck stacked against him.
Oh my God. Broadway got in this.
He was defending that defenseless referee.
This crooked referee.
You're going to justify this?
Look, the Reign of Terror.
He was attacking the ref.
The Reign of Terror on Broadway, and that's it. Look at this bastard. Look at this sick, vile son of a bitch.
He's stroking him goodnight.
Absolutely.
Yes, I'm sure that's what he was doing.
Still.
Someone check this guy's pocket.
You can't trust.
Look at this.
Look, I knew you couldn't trust somebody with that type of mustache, doctor.
You don't know what's in that envelope.
Look at this.
What's in the envelope? Tickets to Dubai, I'm sure, right?
Oh, wait a minute.
Good. Did the job, no need him, though.
Well, there's no honor among thieves.
I don't believe
it. The fix was in, and this is the end result. I don't believe it.
Still,
by the skin of his ass, still the crown jewel champ.
I don't believe this. And he's taking the money back. Look at this.
Of course he is. Look.
Taking the money.
These guys, man. My goodness.
He was just showing him a picture of his sister.
Oh, I'm sure.
But she's way out of his league anyway.
I'm sure.
That's going to do it for us here tonight. Our next YouTube exclusive.
exclusive match comes to you next week when we will see Jonah take on Jeff Cobb. Don't forget to subscribe to HOG on YouTube to see all that and more exclusive content.
This one's different. Him and I are a lot alike. He needs to feed, although he may call it something else. We take our time with this one, trust me. Patience. I'm gonna make him chase his next meal.